It's Wednesday again. Still in Chiang Mai, Thailand, doing the usual house sit around these parts. And today I thought I would talk about, fake news from the left. When I say the left, I mean, you know, left wing versus right wing. Versus maybe is a little sort of controversial, but honestly, when we're fighting for things like human rights, I'm going to consider it a battle. It's okay. I'm very much against the right, so I don't mind stating it that way. However, something that I do mind is the fact that it seems as much as we criticize the right for, you know, fake news, and as much as Donald Trump seems to suggest it's a left-wing problem, I think in some ways it is. I think everyone kind of suffers from it. And a big reason of that seems to be social media. At least from my experience through the Tofu page, with the stats that I'm told, whether or not Facebook is truthful, a lot of people seem to share things and comment on things and react to things that I post without actually reading them. And as far as I'm concerned, that's not a good way to do things, because for all you know, I could be posting something contrary to your ideas, something incredibly blown out of proportion, not factual at all, and yet, you know, you give an opinion and you share it based on the headline or a dramatic picture. And that's not really the way we should be doing things. Even if maybe, you know, what you see agrees already with your opinion or backs up something that you feel is correct, you should be checking sources. You should be reviewing the things you share, and you should be sort of questioning the websites that you share things from. Because I've seen plenty of crappy non-scientific things coming from websites, especially around the plant-based community, that cause a lot of, you know, fear and emotions from things that maybe aren't even factually correct. And that's not the way to win a war, or at least sort of win people over. We have facts on our sides, and I think we have, you know, basically just the right answer. But confirmation bias is an incredibly tricky thing, and it's something that we all need to be aware of, because if we're going to share crappy websites that aren't well-founded in fact, or we're going to, you know, react to things that we don't actually read, we're not doing much better than a lot of people on the right. That's not good. So, I guess what I'm saying is check your sources. Read the things that you react to, and don't share stuff that you haven't looked into. This is the kind of thing that, you know, this is why I push people to include references and Tofu articles. Maybe it's just my, you know, science background, not professionally, but at least in university, that kind of has me thinking that you need references. You have to have facts and research to back up your statements. Just because it feels right to you doesn't mean it's true. So yeah, look into things, do a bit of a better job. As much as I like people reacting to the stuff that I post, above all else, I want them to read it. And I want, you know, to know that you agree with me because you read it. And I just think it's a habit we all need to get into. So that's it. Of course, just like not reading articles, most of you probably haven't finished this video because, 10 seconds is too long, right? It's a sign of the times, but I think we can all do better. And when it comes to things like the left versus the right, we need to do better. As always, thank you for watching. Hope you're having a good evening, a good day, a good night, a good morning, wherever you are. And I'll see you again next week in Chiang Mai, Thailand.